I have a good idea.
What?
Who is it?
It's Beth.
Just a minute. Yes, Beth.
I'm sorry, Calvin, to disturb you, but I really... Come on in, Beth. Calvin.
Now we're going to have to do it again.
Nobody told me it was... I don't know, Calvin. It's been going on for maybe 2 or 3 weeks, maybe longer. I don't know. I don't remember. I don't even remember a time when I didn't feel like this.
Just tell me.
I don't think I can.
Try.
Well, I wake up in the morning and everything is fine. And then as the day goes on, everything starts to change. People that I've known for a long time, suddenly they seem like strangers.
Dee Dee.
Calvin, I know what that sounds like, but you wanted to hear this. Not like a Cliff and Marty. It wasn't so bad at first, but then I began to suspect that they were making fun of me behind my back.
Dee Dee, they wouldn't just...
Calvin! And then I realized that whatever it was that they were up to, it wasn't fun. They were spying on me, Calvin. They are spying on me. They're just waiting for me to make a slip.
Now, what kind of slip?
Calvin, I don't know. I'm not a mind reader. But it's not just them anymore. It's everybody in this building. They're in the lobbies and in the hallways, those little subtle looks and those little sly knowing glances everywhere I turn. Well, Calvin, don't look at me like that.
Dee Dee, I am just trying to understand what is happening here.
That's because you don't believe me.
David, do you remember how you started this conversation?
What do you mean?
You started this conversation by saying there was something wrong with you, and you ended it up by saying there's something wrong with everybody else. Now, this is not the Dee Dee that I know and love.
Calvin, why didn't you tell me that your divorce from Star was final?
Oh, please, Dee Dee, we've been through all that. Look, you and I are together, and I am happier than I have ever been in my life.
Calvin, you lied to me then, and you might be lying to me now.
Oh, please, Dee Dee, listen to yourself. This doesn't make any sense.
Calvin, can I trust you?
Yes.
Oh God, I hope so, because if I can't, I don't know who I can trust.
Didn't mean to startle you, Ms. Bannister.
Isn't Marty out there?
Nope.
Where's Cliff?
I don't know.
How long have you been watching me?
Not long.
I don't like people spying on me.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
Then why did you creep in here so quietly?
Habit, my job. Look, I stopped by because I'm concerned about you.
What do you mean?
Well, I've heard that you're not happy here at the ISIS building.
Now, where did you hear that?
Around.
People are talking about me. strangers are talking about.
Oh, look, not at all. How can I explain it? Sometimes a new environment affects people in odd ways, and I just don't want people to get the wrong idea.
What kind of idea?
That it's the building that upsets you. Look, it's hard enough to get tenants as it is.
Get out of here.
No, he's gonna hurt you, all right? Marty!
No! Get
Marty,
out.
Go get Calvin, all right?
No! Don't gang up on me!
Go! Go!
No,
all right?
No!
Dee, come on!
No!
Calm down, will you? Paramedic! No!
No!
No! What are you talking
no,
about?
No!
Calvin's been on a case.
No!
Calm down.
No!
Calm down.
No!
Calm down. Take it easy. Take it easy.
No!
What's gonna hurt you?
No!
Tim Parker's wife had another baby, a boy. Old Tim was so excited, he went screaming out of the squad room right in the middle of booking a drunken disorderly. Then the drunk starts singing Melancholy Baby at about four different keys. I think it must have taken us an hour to calm him down.
How's Mitzi?
She's fine. You know, Dee Dee, Mitzi would really like to come and see you.
No!
Jody's left the play, you know. Personal reasons. Hey, you remember when we first started dating, there was this movie that we went to see, Wind Chimes.
I remember.
Yeah, well, the girl who was the star of the movie took over Jody's part in the play, Shelley something or other. Anyway, Gavin says the box office is really picking up. Of course, Mitzi was a little miffed that she didn't get to play over her. But, you know, she and Cliff are doing great. We have dinner at the Rock Garden a lot.
The Rock Garden?
Yeah. You remember, that time when Cliff tried to get us back together?
Cliff reserved a table for us at the Rock Garden, and then he told you that I wanted to see you, and then he told me that you wanted to see me.
That's right.
Cliff. Cliff.
You know, things with the detective squad are...
was for us to be happy. Calvin!
Morning.
Oh, I couldn't
go work at my own desk.
Calvin, do you resent the fact that I make more money than you do?
Dee Dee.
That's what I told Dr. Carell.
Look, maybe we ought to discuss something else.
No, I'd like a straight answer. You look very uncomfortable.
I am.
Then I guess I must be right.
Look, I told myself that if you ever got out of here, I was never, ever going to lie to you again, so I'm not about to start now.
Good idea.
Okay, the truth is, yes, I have felt twinges of jealousy, I guess, but they're not about you, and they're not about your personal success. I guess it's just, somewhere inside, I guess I feel like I should be doing better than I am.
I think everybody feels that way at some time or other.
Yeah, well, you see, what I'm trying to do is balance that against the satisfaction that I get from my job, you know, the pleasure that I take in knowing that I actually help people.
I think somebody once said, it's not how far you've come, but how much you've enjoyed the trip.
Yeah, it's like, It's not how much money you make, but what you make of the job.
You really love being a cop, don't you?
Yeah, I guess I really, really do. You believe me?
Thank you for telling me the truth. It makes me feel a lot better. It's an interesting idea, Mr. Nelson, but paranoia isn't catching. Yeah. If it were, in the times we live in, we'd all have it.
I know it sounds strange. You probably think I'm crazy, but I'm not.
No, I know you're not. I can tell these things.
Of course, you can tell these things. Isn't there some sort of emotional disease, though, that can be caught by a large number of people at the same time? Like mass hysteria. Isn't that sort of contagious?
Mass hysteria manifests itself in large groups, in sudden swells of emotion, which manipulate people into certain responses.
Like at political rallies or rock concerts.
Yes, exactly. But what you're talking about is a mental aberration that's transmitted from one person to another like a virus.
Right.
Yes, well, there's no such disease as you describe.
That's what everyone else has been telling me.
Well, don't look so disappointed.
There has to be some explanation for what's going on in this town.
Of course, if there were such a disease as you've described, it would be exactly what's wrong with Dee Dee.
What? What'd you say?
I want to thank you, Mr. Nelson. You've given me... Well, I've been looking at this thing from the wrong angle.
Wait a minute. Wait, what do you mean? You need to explain what you meant.
All right, this really is a much nicer room than the first place they had you in.
I thought I was dangerous. That place is more like a prison cell than a hospital room.
Believe me, it was much worse than a prison cell. I didn't know they actually still had places like that anymore.
You know what, Calvin? People should not be forced to live in places like that.
I know.
Then why doesn't somebody do something?
Dee Dee, you know, things just get kicked under the rug. I mean, reform is like a fad, you know? I mean, the newspapers print stories and people get shocked and the politicians demand answers and... I don't know, I guess something positive happens somewhere along the way, but then that energy sort of fades and it gets replaced by something else in the headlines and... it always ends up being just a whole lot of work that just doesn't get done.
Well, it's not enough.
You're really very serious about this, aren't you?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. And when I get out of here, I'm going to do something to help stir people up again. And I am going to get out of here.
Of course you are.
Hello? Thought I'd drop in again to say hello to my favorite patient.
You know, we were just plotting to rid the world of rooms like the one downstairs.
Mm. What do you think of the idea, Dr. Carell? I think it's a marvelous idea. Well, I've got to get out of here first.
When, Dr. Carell?
Not yet, but soon.
Look, Dee Dee, I gotta take off.
Bye, Calvin.
I'll see you tomorrow, okay? hang in there, baby.
What are you looking at me like that for? Dee Dee, I'd like to ask you something. What? Do you think you're ill? No, of course I don't think I'm ill. I'm not. Then again, I guess I must be, huh? Dr. Carell, could you help me, please? I have begged Dr. Carell at least a dozen times.
And?
And it's the same thing over and over. She says that she can't release me until she's found the root of my problem. My problem! My problem is getting out of this hospital!
Look, Dee Dee, please...
Calvin, no. You, please, help me. Talk to Dr. Carell, make her listen, make her understand that I am well enough to be released. What's the matter?
The matter, Dee Dee, is that I love you.
Calvin, I don't understand.
Dee Dee, listen to me. I'm trying to make you understand that I love you so that I don't want to risk making a mistake that might hurt you.
Oh, I see. What you're really saying is that maybe I should check into the hospital's yearly rates.
No. You know that's not what I'm saying, Dee Dee. You have gotten a lot better since you've been here, but it's been such a short time, baby. Are you absolutely sure
yes.
You are ready to be released?
Yes, I'm sure. I am sure. Safe. Calvin, no one is ever really safe. In here, out there, it's all the same.
Dee Dee, I am scared. Now, I remember how you looked when they brought you in here. I don't think I could live with myself if I had anything to do with making that happen to you again.
But Calvin, I would still see Dr. Carell on an outpatient basis, but you've got to help me get out of here. Calvin, it may seem like a short time to you, but to me, every day has been an eternity.
Now, Dee Dee, you must know how much I want to help. You got to know how much it kills me to see you in this place. The first time I came to see you here, there was so much fear and anger just coming up from inside.
Calvin, everybody has anger inside them. But most people are able to talk about it to the people who caused it. Even Dr. Carell says that my case is different. There is an outside influence that caused my fear and anger to grow. Calvin, don't you see that whatever, whoever it is that put me in this place is still out there somewhere? Now you say you want to help me? Well, then let me help you and Dr. Carell find some answers. Calvin, I've got to know the truth. If it's good or bad, I've got to know, and I can't find it out locked up in a mental ward.
I gotta hand it to you, lady. You really plead one hell of a case.
Then you will help me.
I will do everything I can, baby, to get you out of this place.
Thank you.
Thank you. This could be the start of what might get you out of here. Dr. Carell is convinced that your illness was caused by some sort of outside catalyst.
Catalyst? What kind of catalyst?
Well, she doesn't really know, but there are at least a dozen other people in the ISIS building who have the same symptoms as yours, only not so severe.
Cliff said something like that to me a long time ago. Is he helping her?
No, she's working with Miles Kavanaugh. They're systematically gonna catalog all those cases.
See, I knew it. I knew there was nothing wrong with me. There had to be another reason. Calvin, I'm fine.
No, Dee Dee. It's obvious that there was a lot of resentment and fear going on inside you. This outside force, whatever it is, just brought it out.
I never wanted to admit this to myself before, but Dr. Carell was right. About some of my feelings, there is a lot of anger there. Calvin, I want to fight it. And I need you to help me.
Oh.
We didn't wake you, did we?
I'm not much for sleeping these days.
You were right not to put this off until morning.
Calvin, would you?
I think you should just hear Dr. Curl out.
Dee Dee, as a lawyer, you should be used to a lot of paperwork.
Paperwork?
Because that's the only thing that stands between you and the outside world.
Dr. Curl, are you saying that you're releasing me on one condition?
That you promise to see me every day as an outpatient.
I promise. I promise.
Yes, and I'm going to make double sure she keeps that promise, too.
Well, then, you're free to go in the morning.
Calvin, I can leave?
That's what the lady said.
Oh, I love you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Cliff, I've got some great news. Calvin is back from California, and we're going out to dinner tonight.
Oh, that's good. I hope you enjoy your dinner. Is there something else?
There was this truck driver carrying a shipment of 80 penguins to the local zoo. But halfway there, his truck broke down. But luckily, a second truck driver came by with an empty truck. And so the first truck driver said to the second truck driver, I've got a lot of money riding on this deal, so I'll give you $100 if you'll take these penguins to the zoo for me. So the second truck driver said, sure, piece of cake. Well, anyway, a tow truck came along a little bit later, fixed up the truck and everything, and by this time the poor guy was really starving. So he goes to a local diner, and he's sitting there, and he looks out the window, and there comes a second truck driver walking down the street with 80 penguins walking behind him just like this. And the guy was furious. He runs outside and he says, hey, I thought I gave you money to take those penguins to the zoo. And the second guy said, well, I did, but I had some change left over, so now I'm taking them to the movies. That's a joke.
Yeah, I know. Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
Hope you enjoy your dinner with Calvin.
Thought for a minute you weren't going to open it.
Calvin, I really don't want any company. I told you that.
I know how you feel, Dee Dee. Here. Here are your aspirin.
Thank you.
Look, don't you think it would be better to just talk about it with somebody who cares?
Calvin, do you really expect me to believe that you're as worried about Troy as I am?
After all, Dee, he is your brother.
Calvin, that's not enough. I can't expect you to love him because I love him. I can't expect you to forgive Troy because I want you to. He killed a cop. One of yours. You've got to hate him.
Maybe. If he was someone other than who he is. Dee Dee, I love you. And anybody and anything that's yours and that you love has to mean something to me.
Oh, Calvin. Calvin, what would I do without you? You know, I was hoping all day that you would call me. And I knew that I would ask you not to come over. But I was praying that you wouldn't listen. Oh.
Dee Dee, I think about you so much. You know, sometimes I think that I could deal with anything that happened on the streets during the day. Just if I knew I had you to come home to at night.
And what would you do about the night shift?
Well, it probably wouldn't matter since when I think about you, I can't tell day from night anyway.
Calvin. Would you stay with me tonight?
I'm not going anywhere else.
I love you too. You know that, don't you? You always knew that. You always knew that.
Well, I must admit, it has taken you a long time to coming around to say.
That's because it hurts so much to say it.
Well, that was before. And this is now.
Why, it's ironic that now should come on a night like tonight, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
While you hold me, you talk about my brother. My brother, the fugitive.
Well, look, let's not talk about Troy, at least not just yet. Let's just be together.
Why, yes. Where are you, anyway? I just want to know, that's all. I think I'm entitled to know.
Daddy, who's that?
It's Mitzi. Now, where did you say you were again?
No,
where's
it's
that?
Not Daddy,
what?
It's Troy.
It's Kenneth.
I heard
Stop
you.
It.
Hello, hello? No, you shouldn't have done that. You should have let me talk to him.
Why, so you could trace the call?
Daddy, I would just... I have tried to talk some sense to him, that's all.
Well, do you think you could talk any better to him than his own sister? What were you going to say to him, Calvin? Huh? What were you going to do? Try to threaten him?
I was just going to try to make him understand, that's all.
Oh. Calvin, tell me something. Is that why you came over here tonight? Because you thought Troy might try to get in touch with me?
What?
Well, if you wanted so badly, why aren't you out there with the rest of the cops? Why aren't you out there with the bloodhounds chasing after
you? You are seeing this thing all wrong.
Now I know why you were so willing to spend the night with me. Because you thought Troy might come over here. He would get in touch with me. And then you could bring him in. You could be a big hero. You'd get a commendation and maybe even a...
Damn it, Jimmy, stop it!
No, stop it! Just get out! Get out!
Open the door! Oh, we're coming out.
All right. But don't make any cute moves. Here's the deal. Skip and I are going to get into that car together, and we're going to drive off. Then I'll let him go as soon as I'm sure the cops ain't following me. But the minute I hear a siren, Skipper ain't going to grow a year older. Got it?
Got it? Yeah, we got it.
Hey, you take it easy, Skipper, and you won't get hurt. Come on.
Now, just what do you two think you're doing?
Look, I'm taking Skipper with me. If anybody tries to stop me, I'll try.
Why? Who do you think you're kidding? You wouldn't hurt Skipper any more than you would a kitten. He knows that. I know that. And you know that. Skipper's been like a second father to you.
Troy!
You don't hurt somebody who gave you your first baseball. Somebody who tied your shoes for you. Somebody who's to spank your behind when you needed it. Why don't you just knock it off, Troy, and forget all this play acting and just give yourself up? Troy, give me the gun! Give me the gun, Troy. Give me the gun. Give it to me.
Thank you.
dearly beloved, we are gathered here to unite in holy wedlock this loving couple.
All right, here we go.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah, the question is, will you feed me tomorrow?
Now all I need is a bride to go with it.
And who is that?
Oh, he's a paralegal who works in our firm.
Yeah, ambitious young guy going to school at night. He's graduating in June.
Wait, right, I started night school last semester. Yeah. Business administration.
Way to go.
Oh, I'm so proud of you.
Yeah. From juvenile delinquent to businessman. In a few short years.
Congratulations.
That's my brother. Didi.
Kelvin said you'd be having dinner here. Has he arrived yet?
No, he called to say that he was going to be a little late. He's checking out a couple of leads on Liz and Chris.
You're nuts. I've got to talk to him.
But you know what? As long as you're here, could I talk to you for a minute?
Sure.
Since you're a working woman and a mother.
A working woman and a... Oh, wait a minute. Does this have something to do with little bundles of joy?
Kelvin told you?
He told me that you two were talking about having a baby and that you were a little hesitant because of your work.
And what did you say?
Well, I told him that I thought he should understand if you want to concentrate on your legal career right now.
Well, that was definitely true, all right.
Was true?
I thought I had it all planned out. You know, 3 or 4 years working very hard on my career, taking 3 or 4 months off to have a baby, and then getting right back to work, and I thought Kelvin was prepared to accept that. Doesn't make any difference now, though. It's all changed.
Why's that?
I'm pregnant.
I'm sorry I'm late.
Hi, Kelvin.
Well, I get the feeling I just missed something.
Well, here's your club soda, and the wine is on its way.
Good, you're gonna need it.
Okay, ladies, I think it's time this little game was up. What's the big secret?
You're on your own, okay? Good night. Okay, so you want the long or the short?
Just talk.
We are going to have a baby.
You mean you changed your mind about Wade?
No, I mean I'm pregnant. Now.
Not. Dee Dee. Wait a minute. You're not telling me that now that this has happened, you do want to have it.
Yeah. I do want to be a mother.
I'm so glad to hear you say that. Oh, Dee Dee, you're going to be a fantastic mother, too. All right, career mother, I know. But, look, we can make the adjustments. I know how important a law firm is, too.
I think maybe I can have the baby over the weekend and be back in court on Monday.
That might be a little too soon.
Yeah, I guess so. But I do want our baby and my career too.
And your husband?